Coming up next is Terry Payne with some public information you might find interesting.
In the springtime, people think about spring cleaning, and that's actually something that the City of Hot Springs can help you with. And today, with me is Sanitation Director Bill Burrow. Welcome, Bill.
Good morning. How are you?
Just fine. Let's talk about the CAP service that's been in place with the city for a number of years, but there may be people out there that are not aware how it can help them with their spring cleaning. What does CAP stand for?
Well, CAPS is a service that's provided by the Sanitation Department. It stands for Clean Attractive Property Service, and basically what it is our knuckle boom, large bulky item collection. A lot of residents will have, you know, things that just won't fit in a garbage can or, maybe a couch, maybe a stove, maybe something large and bulky that they need help getting rid of.
So when they do have these items to get rid of, how do they contact Sanitation to arrange for a pickup?
It's a great question. All they have to do is call our office at 321-6911 or 321-6921 is even a better number for our CAPS. And basically they'll ask them a couple of questions. What type of debris is it? Is it a metal item? Is it a stove? Is it a hot water heater? Is it a couch? Maybe it's large brush. And they'll just call and schedule. And every resident is afforded 2 free collections a year up to 1 ton.
Now, why do you separate the items that you collect for pickup and have different collection days?
Well, each item is managed separately. You know, most of our residents, they just want to put it on the curb and make sure it disappears, and we certainly want to make that happen. However, the way we manage it is different for each item. Some of our brush, for instance, that we pick up on Mondays and Thursdays, all of that will go to the compost, and if it's too large, we'll take it to our Garland County landfill. Again, those same items, Tuesday and Friday, we pick up miscellaneous, you know, the couches and large bulky furniture, basically, and that goes to our landfill, Class 4 landfill. And then on Wednesdays, we pick up all of those metal goods, and we like to call them white goods. It may be washers, dryers, stoves, hot water tanks, those kind of things, and we can recycle those.
Excellent. Now, what about items with refrigerant in them?
Refrigerants is a little bit of a different animal in itself because, of course, they have some hazardous components to it. We collect those as well. We'll collect those pretty much Monday through Friday, but normally we'll try to get those scheduled on Wednesdays as well. I have 2 technicians at the department that their primary function is to reclaim all of that Freon or R12 or whatever gas is in that unit. We test each one, we reclaim it, and then we recycle and resell that gas as well.
Now, as you can see with the pickup that we're looking at today, there are power lines nearby. Are there special rules regarding power lines and where you place your items for pickup?
There are. Any resident that calls and schedules a collection, they'll need to make sure that they have about 20 feet of clearance up above, so we're not getting into any type of power line. All of our equipment is metal, and of course we just can't put our gentlemen at safety risk. Plus, we don't want to tear down any of those lines. We also ask that they do the same for branches. We use large equipment. We can either break branches or something like that. And just, we need 20 foot of clearance up above. We ask that everything be placed at curbside and it's out there at least by 6 a.m. the day of your collection.
Now, sometimes there are weekend warriors out there for whom 2 pickups a year is just not enough. You know, they continually have large items that need to be picked up. Can they make arrangements with you?
Certainly. I mean, this service, they can use it as often as they like. We do offer, as I said, 2 free collections every year up to 1 ton. But residents are welcome to schedule as many collections as they need to suit their needs.
And how about the elderly and the disabled who might need some help?
We will make accommodations for that. I mean, we realize that we're in a community that do have residents that aren't able to lift some of these heavier items. If they call and make arrangements ahead of time, we'll try to help them out with that as well.
So the key is to call and ask what you need.
That is correct.
Okay.
One of the things I want to bring up, though, are some of our flyers or door hangers is what we call. If a resident has some things out on the curb but did not call to get it scheduled, we do sweeps and, we try to keep our neighborhoods and our roads clean. So if we see something that's out, we'll call. If it's not scheduled, we'll leave a little reminder letting them know, hey, please give us a call and schedule those items. If not, after they receive this, we track it. And within 7 days, based on city ordinance, we collect those and then we'll follow our charge procedures as well once we do that.
And CAPS is available for commercial use also?
That is correct. We do have services for our commercial use. There is a charge for our commercial establishments. And again, that's based on what they have out there and how much.
Well, Bill, we've covered a lot of ground where the CAPS service is concerned, and our time is out. But if you have any questions about CAPS or you want to schedule a pickup, again, what is the number?
321-6921, and we look forward to hearing from you.
Thank you, Bill. And next week, we'll bring you more city news.